everyone, welcome back to another session on dentistry and more. So today we have a mixed dentition model analysis, that is Moyer's analysis. So this analysis is different from permanent tooth analysis that we have seen in last session, that is Bolton's analysis. That was completely permanent tooth model analysis. So this is a mixed dentition analysis. So the difference is, in mixed dentition analysis, as name suggests, it has both deciduous and permanent teeth. So in Moyer's analysis, what we are trying to find out is the prediction of space required from the available teeth. So from the available few teeth, we are predicting the space discrepancy for the future upcoming teeth. So that is the concept. Basic armamentarium is dental cast, Boley's cage, and probability chart. It's very common, but the main thing is probability chart. So we are going to predict the future teeth discrepancy or future available tooth requirement, space requirement, by a probability chart idea. So the step one, what we are going to do, we are going to measure the mesio-distal width of incisors, so most commonly mandibular. So mesio-distal dimension of mandibular arch, that is 1 2 1 2. So this mesio-distal width we are going to measure. So the lower incisors mesio-distal width we measured. Okay, so this is the lower incisor measure. So in cast we measure with Boley's cage the mesio-distal width of 4 incisors. The second step is measure the distance, that is space, from distal surface of lateral incisor to the mesial side of permanent first molar. So hope you can see the number. This is permanent central incisor, permanent lateral incisor, deciduous canine, deciduous first molar, deciduous second molar, permanent first molar. So we measured the mesio-distal dimension of central and lateral incisor. The second step is measure the distance or the space from distal surface of lateral incisor to the mesial aspect of permanent first molar. So this length is the second. So what we are going to do is, next step is, we have Moyer's chart, that is a prefixed chart for particular measurement, and we find out the mesio-distal width of canine and premolars. So this is the space where the future canine and premolars will be erupting, because deciduous canine will be replaced by permanent canine and deciduous molars will be replaced by premolars. So we are going to predict the mesio-distal width of canine and premolars from the chart, and we can easily determine the arch length discrepancy because we are checking from the Moyer's chart. So this is a mixed dentition analysis. And why the mandibular incisors have been chosen? So the mandibular incisors have been chosen because they erupted early in the mouth and easily measured accurately, and they are directly in the midst of most space management problem. So these are the reasons why we are taking the mandibular incisor. And maxillary incisors are not chosen because the variability in size and their correlation with other groups of teeth are of lower predicted value. Okay, so it is not maxilla, it is mandible. Mandible is checked because of its advantage over the maxilla, because maxilla incisors having variability in size and the correlation with the teeth are with of a lower predicted value. So that is why we are choosing mandibular incisors. So that's all about Moyer's analysis. It is a very simple analysis in mixed dentition period. Only thing, we are measuring the incisors and predicting the canines and premolar space. Okay, so we have to measure it and we have to compare these values with the probability, Moyer's probability chart. So I'll come up with the actually how analysis in my next video. Thank you.